Hi, I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip. This is COMP1010, and today I'm going to be talking to you about a common problem, scaling values from one range to another. And we'll do this in processing. So, the common scaling problem is that often you have a number that's in one range, and then you need it in another range. So we talk about maybe the source range and the destination range. So here's an example of what I mean. Suppose you have the horizontal position of the cursor. That's specified by mouse X. And it goes from zero to width, which is the left side of the canvas to the right side. And maybe you want the volume of a sound that's playing to range from 10 decibels up to 30 decibels. And you want that volume to increase as the mouse moves across the canvas. So you want it to be 10 when the mouse is at zero on the canvas, and you want it to be 30 when the mouse is over at the far right, specified by the width of the canvas. And as it moves across, you want it to change gradually. So here in this case, we have a source range, which is defined by zero to width, and the specific current setting is mouse X. And we have a destination range, which is the volume from 10 to 30. So we need to figure out how to do that mapping. Here's another example. Maybe you have color changing in your animation. So perhaps the red value of your animation is slowly going from 100 to 255. And maybe you want a ball's vertical position to move from the bottom of the screen to halfway up the screen as the red value increases. So in this case, the source range is a red value, and it goes from 100 to 255. And the destination range is the ball's Y position. And if we wanted to go from the bottom of the screen to the halfway up the screen, that range is from height to height divided by 2. So these are scaling problems, and we need to do some math to solve them. So here's the math. The first is kind of a two-step approach, and I think this is the easiest to sort of think through. So what we're going to do is we're going to get a number from 0 to 1, which represents the percentage of the current setting within the source range. So we're going to say float source percent, and we're going to take the source setting and subtract the minimum of the range. And then we're going to divide that by the size of the range, which is the source max minus the source min. This gives you the whole size of the source range. And so this gives us a percentage. It tells us where the current setting is within that source range. So in the mouse volume, in the mouse to audio volume example, we would do float mouse percent equals mouse X minus 0, which is the minimum end of the range, the left side of the canvas, divided by width minus 0, which is the entire span of the range, which is the width of the canvas. And so we can calculate that out. This simplifies, of course, because we have some zeros in here. So our mouse percent is mouse X divided by the width. But you want to be careful here. We've already talked about the issues of integer division and then assigning to a float. This is an integer and this is an integer, so that would give us zero no matter where the mouse was. So we actually probably want to cast one of these values to a float, and that will ensure that we get float division and the mouse percent is the correct 0. Whatever. Okay, once we've got that percent, then we want to use that to get our value in the desired range. So here we say float answer, and we say the destination, in the destination range, what's the minimum setting? And then we're gonna add source percent from up here multiplied by the range and the destination. So destination max minus destination min. Okay, so in our mouse to audio volume example, then what we're trying to get is a volume setting, and we're going to take volume min, whatever that is, I think we said it was 10, we're going to add to it our mouse percent multiplied by the volume range, okay? So you don't actually have to do this in two steps. You could sort of combine these two things into one formula. So here's the two steps. We get the percentage, and then we put that percentage, this should say source percent, in here. You can do it all at once though. So here's a formula. We say value in new range equals the destination min plus, and this part here is sort of the source percent. multiplied by the destination range. So you can put this all into one formula. So here we would have, if we wanted to do this with our mouse volume, we would say volume setting equals volume min plus mouse x minus 0 divided by width minus 0. So this gives us the percentage in the mouse movement range. And we multiply that by volume max minus volume min, which is the range in our destination. And then you can also look at this and say, well, wait a second, I might have an integer division issue, so we have to solve that here by doing this. Okay. So here's an example. Maybe we have color changing in an animation, the red value. So let's look at that red value example. And we want the ball's vertical position to move from the bottom of the screen to halfway up the screen as the red value increases. So in this case, our source range is the red value from 100 to 255, and our destination range is the ball's Y position. And we want it to be from the bottom of the screen, which is height, to halfway up the screen, which is height divided by 2. So in the two-step approach, we have the red percent is the red val minus the red min, divided by the red max minus the red min. So we have red val minus 100 divided by 255 minus 100, and this simplifies to red val minus 100 divided by 155. And of course, we have to be careful here of integer division. So here we can make one of these numbers a float. So we could cast by casting it to an int, or we could just turn this into a float by doing 155.0. And that will give us the floating point division. And then we put this into the destination range. So now we have our answer, which is going to be the vertical position to be destination min plus this percent times the destination max minus the destination min. So here, ball y is going to be ball y min plus the red percent times the ball y max minus the ball y min. And so here we have the min is the height at the bottom of the screen, plus the red percent times the height divided by 2 minus the height. And we actually, if I look at this, we have a little typo here because we really need to put 2 minus height in brackets. Okay, and then of course we could do this all at once. And so you can sort of look through the math here. Again, we are, if I look here, we're missing brackets around the 2 minus height because we've got to do that subtraction before we do the division. And so let's have a look at what this might look like in an actual example in processing. All right, so here we go. We have here a script that does a ball. We have a ball that's going up and down the screen. So let's play this and see what happens. So this is a ball that's just falling continually. So we've got ball x starts in the middle with the type divided by height and height divided by 2. And we are adding 2 to the ball x, so that's giving us the sort of slight horizontal movement. And we're adding 4 to ball y, which is making the ball look like it's falling. And we're modulating both of these by width and height so that it keeps coming back to the top of the screen. We're just drawing this ball. And the ball is filled with this reddish color, 200 and then 50-50 for blue and green. So what we want now is we want to map the red color of this ball to the y coordinate so that it's less red up at the top of the screen and more red as it gets down to the bottom of the screen. And so we're going to use our formulas. So in this case, our source range is the y coordinate, which goes from 0 down to height. And our destination range is the red value, which we want to be high. So we'll make that range be from a red val of 100 up to 255. Okay, and so our formula is the value in the new range equals the destination min plus the source value minus the source min divided by the source max minus the source min. That part there is our percentage. And then we're gonna multiply this all by the range in our destination. So let's make this happen. So we're going to say float red val, so that's our value in the new range, equals the destination min. So in the destination range of the red, we want the min to be 100. And then we say plus source val minus source min. So our source val is the y coordinate. So ball y minus the source min, so the lowest that our ball y can be is 0. And I'm going to simplify this after. And we're going to divide that by source max minus source min. So our source max is height minus our source min, which is 0. And then we're going to multiply all of this by our destination max minus our destination min. So our destination max is in the red range. We want it to be 255 minus, and the destination min is 100. Okay, so now we've got some zeros in here, so we can kind of simplify this. So we can get rid of the minus 0. So we're just doing divide by height. And we can get rid of the ball y minus 0. So we've just got ball y divided by height. And we want to make sure we're not doing integer division here. So height is an int, but we've actually got ball y specified as a float here. So this will do floating point division. So that's good. And then we're going to multiply it by this range. And so we can actually simplify this. We can just say 255 minus 100 is obviously 155. And we don't need to have that in brackets. Okay, so that should give us a red val that changes as the height of the ball changes. And we just need, of course, to use our red val in our fill instruction. So let's stop this and have a look. And so what we see here is up at the top, it's dark red, sort of a darker red. And as we get down to the bottom, it's becoming a much brighter red. Okay, so that's an example of scaling where we're taking values in one range and using that to map to values in another range. All right, hope that helps. Thanks for watching.